Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to talk to you about InDesign. Now, in the past, I have come across a problem where you create a document with spreads for your client because they want to see it, how it would be laid out if it were in book form. But then your printer wants single pages with crop marks. And there are actually two problems that can arise from this. First, when you change it from facing pages to single pages, it can really mess with your page numbering. So if you set up your master pages as spreads, it's going to kind of mess them up. You really have to make sure that your page numbers are correct after that. And then the other problem is the bleeds are missing on one side. So I'm going to show you the best way to solve this. We will have to do a little bit of work with the bleeds, but the page numbering should fix itself once we create the document this way. So let's go to InDesign. So I've got a multi-page little booklet here. It has 8 pages. So this is the cover and it will not have any page numbers. And then I've got page numbers on the inside, all coming from master page B for the white ones, and then dark page numbers that are coming from master pages A. And these are all spreads because my client always wants to view this in booklet form whenever they get the PDF. So when I save a PDF for my client, it's going to look like this. We'll just go to File, Export. And we'll choose spreads here. And now this is what my client's going to see. The cover, the first inside spread, and the second one, and then the back page. But my printer is going to need a different type of file. And some printers are okay with you sending them spreads, but my actual in real life printer always wants single pages with bleeds on them. So if we change this to single pages right now, let's see what happens. I'm going to go to File, Document Setup, and we'll change this to single pages. We'll get rid of facing pages and say okay. And now if we look at page 2, this is fine. But when we get to page 3, it put my page number over here on the wrong side. It should be over here. The old way, if I back up one, the page number 3 is on the right side. On the single pages version, it's on the left. So that is a problem. So to fix this, instead of changing this to single pages, I'm going to save a copy of it. And we'll call this one single pages. So we'll come up here to the pages flyout and uncheck allow document pages to shuffle. And this is really important. You have to uncheck this. I'm going to click page 3 and pull it until I get this line. That will keep my page number on the right side, but I'll have single pages. And I'll do the same here and then the same here. So that actually fixes one of my problems. That will keep the page numbers where they should be. So we have page 2 here on the left side. And we've got page 3 here, and that page number is on the right side. Now the other problem we have is that my printer wants bleeds on all 4 sides, and that is something we're going to just have to manually adjust. Right now, the edge of the page is here. It's kind of hard to see it. And then the bleed section is the red area. As long as this blue part is going all the way out to the red, I'm good to go. And it is on this cover page. And we come over here and it's going all the way out to the red here on any part that bleeds off. But here you can see it's not going all the way out here. So I'm going to just pull this over like this. And we'll also just pull this out. Same here, we'll have to pull this over to the red area. And here's a problem to fix. And another one. And then finally, we're at the back page, which already has full bleed all the way out past the red part. So now if we save this, this is my version for the printer, and they're going to want crops and bleeds. So I'm going to export, and I'm going to choose pages instead of spreads, come to marks and bleeds, crop marks, and then we'll also use the document bleed settings, which I've already set up to be 0.9 or 0.125 inches. So we'll export that. And now I'll open this PDF and see what we've got. We've got a good full bleed going over the edges of the crop marks, which is awesome. Doing good still. And I always go through and check every single page to make sure the bleeds are all there and correct. We've got some weirdness going on here, but that's actually a problem with this ebook template. It's not a design I'm actually printing in real life, so I'm not gonna worry about it, but Also check your patterns because they might be doing something funky. Bleeds are going all the way past the edges of the crop marks, which is great. So this is exactly what my printer wants, and it's a pretty easy fix. There is some work involved, but it's a good fix for the page numbering and bleed problem. I hope this video helped you solve the single pages versus facing pages problem and getting it to a printer the way the printer wants it versus what your client wants to see. If you like this video, please click on the like button, and I will see you next week for another graphic design tutorial. Thank you.